All right, y'all, so long-awaited video. I already know what I eat in a day to get jacked and successful. These are the two things that I care about the most right now, right? Obviously having good relationships, all of that, but at the end of the day, you have to make sure that your diet works for you. And disclaimer, I'm not saying that this is gonna work for everybody. I'm not saying that everyone should do this, but if this is something that you wanna try because it's interesting, feel free to do it. This is just what I've done. This is what I've enjoyed the most. This is what's given me the most time out of my day to be able to focus on my businesses. This is what's given me the most nourishment when it comes to nutrition for me. I felt the best on this specific diet that I'm about to show you. But without further ado, I had to put those disclaimers aside. I'm not a bodybuilder. I'm not trying to be even a fitness influencer. I'm just a guy who, is trying to get jacked and successful, right? Have a good business, have a good body, right? And have good health, have good longevity. But at the end of the day, again, make sure that you are focusing on what's going to work for you. Try these different styles. Try this style. It may be perfect for you. And I'll give you explanations on why certain things work for me and why certain things don't, or why I'm doing specific types of meals throughout the day. So I'll give you a summary of everything, and then I'll kind of go through each one as I eat it, and then I'll explain why it is the optimal thing for me at that specific time. So right now I'm drinking about 24 ounces of water with Himalayan sea salt. I sprinkle like a pinch of Himalayan sea salt in there. I down that this first thing in the morning. It's around 7 a.m. right now. I usually get up around 5:30, but I gave myself a little bit of time just to kind of, recover and have a better start to the day. Because I had a late night last night. But 24 ounces of water with Himalayan sea salt first thing in the morning. After that, I get about, I think this is about 8 ounces of coffee. Black coffee. I only drink black coffee. And so I drink 2 to 3 of these a day, which people can say is healthy, is unhealthy. But I think if you are exerting mental energy when you're working, or you're actually putting to use the caffeine, I think it's worth it, right? If you're just drinking coffee just to drink coffee, I don't think you should be drinking 3. You could probably drink 1 and be fine. But for me, it's a stimulant for me. I like it. I need it. So I drink about 2 to 3 per day, and I'll drink 24 ounces of water in between. So I only have the Himalayan sea salt with the first glass of water of the day, and then the rest of the time it's just regular water. And so I'll consume that in alternate. So every cup of coffee that I drink one tall glass of water. And so this is how I'm pretty much going to be from the time I wake up, which typically, again, is like 5. Right now it's 7, but I'll go up until 10 o'clock. At 10 o'clock, I'll break this kind of mini fast with fruit. And I'll eat a significant amount of fruit. It's simple carbs. It kind of helps me with the sugars and all that type of stuff, and like kind of help me have a little bit more energy, have a little bit more kick without consuming any food, because I don't want to start eating until 1 o'clock. The reason for that is because I want to be in that starvation mode. I want my brain to kind of be in that fight or flight. Like, I need food. I'm hungry. It helps me a lot with focusing. It helps me a lot with just overall just doing better in business. Everything right now is optimized for business and health, right? And like making sure that I feel as optimal as possible. I perform the best. So that's why I hold out up until like late 1 o'clock. And then I break the fast with meat, because I do believe meat and fats, right? So I'll have chicken thighs. I'll have either steak or ground beef. And then I'll have avocados, and I have a lot of that all in one, and that'll be like my meat portion for the day, right? So I'll consume that. And then from there, I'll also have complex carbs towards around 6 o'clock, 6 or 7 o'clock. So from 1 to 4, I'm eating straight meat and fats. And then from 5 to 6, I'm eating more like carbohydrates, and I might add some Greek yogurt to it as well towards the end, just to kind of help with digestion. It has probiotics in there as well, but I'll have some Greek yogurt, some granola, and some honey in there, right before I go to sleep, or like 3 hours before I go to sleep. And so that is pretty much my structure right now, as at a high level. And I'll also explain just as I do it, why each of these things are important to me and why I do what I do. So tune in. I'm glad that y'all are with me today for my full day of eating, but I'm excited to show you what's up. All right, y'all. So it's about 11:52 right now. So this is basically me breaking my fast, my coffee, water fast that I'm doing. Typically around 12, but I'm eating a little bit earlier because I want to make this video before my first call or second call of the day. And then essentially, I like to eat fruit, like just to break it, because it gives me a lot more energy. Like for me, fruit is energy to me. And again, this might not work for you. Maybe you need to, you know, eat a hefty breakfast in the morning to get energy because you feel like that's what you need. For me, I've experimented with a lot of things, and fruit, like for me, this is what keeps me going. This is what gives me that spike of energy that I need. The sugars in it really help me. And I'm drinking a lot of water, right? I'm consuming some coffee as well. So the energy flows, and this is going to propel me to between 1 to 4 o'clock, have like my bigger meal of the day. I'm still going to be hungry after this, right? Because it's fast acting carbs for me. And typically I like to eat this before I work out, but I ended up eating it after just because just my schedule permitted for that. So that's another thing with this, right? Like this is all schedule optimized. This is all allows for me to move throughout the day. Again, this is not a bodybuilder meal plan that, you know, has all these different, you know, macros. I'm beyond that at this point, right? So if you're at a point where you really just want to live life and really enjoy the foods that you're eating without having to track a bunch of, you know, calories that you're consuming, and really just like focus on whole foods. That's the biggest thing I'll say. Focus on whole foods and you should be all right. Like the minute you start eating, you know, artificial foods or things that are processed, that's when you need to start tracking your macros, right? Because they have different ingredients in them that are just not catered to the person who's actually trying to either lose weight or lose fat, whatever that looks like build muscle. You want to make sure that you're eating whole food. It's really hard to overeat whole foods. I'm telling you, like if you just ate whole foods for your entire life, you would never be fat. You just couldn't. You couldn't overeat whole foods. I can't overeat fruit. I can't overeat, you know, chicken thighs and ground beef and avocados, which is what I'm gonna have in my next meal. I can't overeat that stuff. I get satiated very quickly. So that's why you see other people in other countries, because their ingredients are a lot more organic and they don't have processed foods. That's why they're able to remain lean. That's why when you go to Italy, they eat pasta, but the pasta is not completely processed. So that's why they're always so lean. That's why they're always so in shape. You know what I'm saying? Like they're beautiful people. And so I like to, you know, break my fast again with fruit to really give me that energy spike in the middle of the day around 12 o'clock when I really need it, and then transition into my next meal, which you're going to see. But it's just a bowl of fruit. I don't calculate how much fruit it is. I know some of you guys are very autistic when it comes to food and meal plans because, again, you're focused on it, and I totally understand. But I want you to just start eating whole foods. Just start with that. With what I'm doing right now, I'll tell you what some of the macros are. But at the end of the day, just eat whole foods. The amount doesn't matter as much in terms of, oh, am I overeating? You will never overeat eating whole foods, I promise you. So if you do this method, it's going to be a lot easier for you. I don't have a scale. I don't have things to weigh. I used to do it when I was bodybuilding. I used to eat completely different when I was bodybuilding. I would have oatmeal in the morning and, you know, eggs and you know, just protein shake. And I just felt real lethargic. I felt really tired. You know, the human body, like as a man especially, when you're out and you're hungry, you want to go hunt for food, right? So that triggers in your brain. And again, maybe this isn't scientific, but this is how I feel. When I'm hungry, I get a lot more agitated and I also get a lot more driven. I have a fire under me to like go harder, right? So that's why I do what I do. That's why I consume food the way that I do, because it aligns with the patterns that work best for me. So this is, again, the first meal of the day. But yeah, I'll see you on the next video or the next portion of this video where I'm actually just going to go through and show you how I cook my chicken, my ground beef, what I use for seasoning, avocado, how that meal looks, so you can understand kind of like what that bigger meal looks like in the middle of the day. So I'm going to see you in a little bit. All right, y'all. So this is the next phase. This is going to be my meat that I eat. So I always say this, like, fruit in the morning, and then I break the fast.
I do my protein for the most part. Again, this is not normal. This is not what bodybuilders do. This is not what fitness influencers do. This is what Martell does. So if you like this, try it, but it's not for everybody. And I'll explain when I'm eating why I do this, but I start off, I have chicken drumsticks and I usually wash them in lemon because it's the cleanest. You don't want to use water. So I'm probably only gonna make one, two, three. Yeah, I can make about five of these right now. Put this in the sink. And I usually wash my hands after because you don't want salmonella. So with chicken, you know, Americans don't really know how to make chicken very well. You know, they don't season anything. They don't put anything on. They just make food. Well, I'm Caribbean, so we season stuff. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna cut this lemon in half. So I'm just gonna get this here. Make sure all of it hits. And I basically mix it up, make sure it's clean. And then wash my hands after. And then while I'm seasoning this, what I wanna do is I wanna put this temperature up to probably about 400. So I'll preheat it to about 400. Let's look here. We want bake. I like to do 400 so I can only spend 20 minutes with this. So I'll preheat this. Then I'll put the seasonings in because nobody puts seasonings in, but I do. So we're good. So you can pick whatever seasoning you want. I like these. I like Lowry's. I like the steak blend. Well, actually, I'm not using the steak blend for the chicken. That's for the beef. And then I use garlic salt. Very simple. And then black pepper. Just make sure you get everything in there. We do this here. And this. And I usually throw some oil in there just so it can be oiled up. So I'll grab my extra virgin olive oil. And yeah, we're good. So I'll mix this up here. Might add a little bit more Lowry's in there. See, I can never go vegan again. Never in my life. It's the worst experience I've ever had. So I have to incorporate meat in, and this is the best time. It's around 4:50 right now. So I give myself up until 7 to eat everything. After this, I'll probably have Greek yogurt, granola, honey, and then I'll have like a salad at the very end of the day, which digests really well for me before I go to sleep. I don't really want to eat any carbs right now. Today I don't feel the need to, so I probably won't have much, but this is how I pretty much season the chicken. And so I'll leave this here. And so I'm going to wait for this preheat to go off, and then I'll put the chicken on the tray with the aluminum foil. I'll put a little bit more olive oil in it as well. Fats are really good for you. People think fats make you fat, but they don't. They're actually really good just for your body in general. So I'll have an avocado with everything, which I'll cut up at the end. And then the chicken has healthy fats in it, like olive oil. So that's what I'm gonna do with the chicken. And then the beef, I'm gonna cook that on the pan. And so I'll cook that for a little bit. I'll put the rest of the normal seasoning that I typically put on it. I'll add the steak blend to it. And that's really gonna be what I eat for the day, or for the 4 hour window that I have. So I'll have all of that, and then I'll eat that all at once, and then I'll give myself time to digest. All right, so now we're about to put the chicken in the oven for about 25 minutes. Let that cook in there. So let's do timer, 25. May do it a little bit longer because I like when chicken's fully cooked, because it's supposed to be fully cooked. And then now we're gonna make the beef too. So this, again, I use just quick olive oil. I don't measure anything because I don't see a reason to measure. With this, I kind of know what I need to do. Let me put a little bit more in there. Then we're really gonna wait for this to heat up. All our spices here too. In between that, I'm gonna crack all my eggs. So I usually have 3 eggs as well. Over here. And I'll season the eggs as well. I like seasoned food. I just have to. And I'll throw this in there as well. And some black pepper. So I usually cook the eggs after I make the beef. So everything's gone, and then I'll put the eggs in whatever's in the beef so I don't have to use another pan. I'm just lazy sometimes, so I have to do it like that. Then I'll add some hot sauce to it. This is still getting hot. And then just old-fashioned whip. This is a secret. Y'all make your eggs way too plain. You gotta spice it up a little bit, you know? Leave that there. We got the ground beef. I'm gonna cut this. Then I just break it up. And all this should take you like 15 to 20 minutes max. 20 minutes to get everything done. And you can make this for multiple days. I just like to do it every day because I like to. And I'll throw some seasoning in there. My favorite one, kind of. That's a little bit of garlic salt. Just a little bit. All right, so this should be ready to go. So we're gonna keep the flame on because we're gonna put the eggs on after. So we're just gonna put this here. So there's that. Then what we wanna do, wanna throw the eggs that we just whipped up here into whatever's simmering. double check. Make sure this is doing good. Yep. Cut this avocado up. And I don't care if it's cut completely, like, perfect. We don't care. We just want everything to go inside anyway, so it don't really matter. All right, we about to get this chicken out now. That's what I like to hear. Okay. So let's put these on the plate. So as you guys can see, this is the biggest meal I'm gonna eat today. Probably around 3,000 calories, or 2,400 or 500 calories. So we have eggs, three eggs. We have a whole thing of beef, 80-20. So it's 80% lean, 20% fat, right? And then we have avocado. I do a whole avocado, and then five drumsticks. And then I added some Brazil nuts. It's like 200 calories for every like five, and I put 10 in there, so that's just an extra caloric intake for me. But this is what I eat. Everybody will say that this is not healthy, but it's healthy for me. I feel good afterwards, and clearly the results show. So this is my second meal of the day that I'm eating. I look forward to the third one with you guys. Thank you. All right, so this is the last meal of the day. We have not Greek yogurt, it's whole milk yogurt because I like the fats in it. We have protein, peanut butter, granola, and then we have a drizzle of honey, and then my salad with green goddess dressing from Trader Joe's. So this is what I eat at the end of the day. Keep my digestion going with the probiotics, then I have my greens too, and this is all I eat in a day. It's a lot for most people, but for me, this is what I need. Try it out. Let me know what you think about it. Don't try it out either. If you don't like it, it's up to you, but this is what I eat in a day. This is what you guys wanted. So thank you for joining this video and watching, and I'll see you on the next video.